In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the evaluation of arithmetic expressions, or we can write here evaluation of arithmetic expressions. So in generally, or we can say the conventional way of writing an expression with operators and operands is called infix, because the operators come in between the operands. For example, we can write a plus b. Here a is one operand and b is another operand, and plus is the operator. So we can write here this is one operand, a b is one operand, a is also one operand, and this plus is the operator. And you can see here the operator plus is placed in between two operands. So this type of notation is called as infix notation. Similarly, you can take some more examples. Suppose 2 plus 3 that is equal to 5. So this 2 plus 3 is also one mathematical or arithmetic expression that is expressed using infix notation. Similarly, you can take another one, 2 plus 3 multiplication 4. So here plus is one operator, multiplication is one operator, and these operators are placed in between operands, and this is also called as infix notation. Now we will take one more example. Suppose 2 plus 3 multiplication 5. So we know that here multiplication has higher precedence, so multiplication is going to be evaluated first. So its result is 2 plus 12 and it is equal to 14, because multiplication has higher precedence than addition, so we need to perform the multiplication operation first. So in infix notation, to fix the order of evaluation, we assign priority to the operators. So here multiplication has higher priority than addition, and suppose exponentiation operation is there. Suppose 2 exponentiation 3 plus 2, or you can take this one plus 2 exponentiation 3 plus 4. So here this exponentiation operation has higher precedence than addition. So this 2 exponentiation 3 that is equal to 8 plus 4, it is equal to 12. So to fix the order of evaluation in infix notation or in infix expression, we assign priority to each operator, and we know that exponentiation has higher priority, then multiplication and division, then addition and subtraction. If we consider only arithmetic operators, or we can say if we consider only these five operators, five arithmetic operators, exponentiation has higher precedence, then multiplication and division has same precedence, and then plus and minus has same precedence. So exponentiation has highest and plus and minus has lowest precedence, have lowest precedence. And we can use parentheses to override the priority of order of evaluation. Suppose here in this example 2 plus 3 multiplication 4, so generally it is 2 plus 12 that is equal to 14. Now we can use parentheses to override the priority in the order of evaluation, or we can say if I write in this way 2 plus 3 multiplication 4, and if I give parenthesis here, so first this addition is going to be evaluated. So we can write 5 multiplication 4, then it is equal to 20. Now if we design a computer algorithm, or if we write a program to evaluate an arithmetic expression that is written in infix notation, then it is very difficult to write the program, or it is very difficult to design a computer algorithm to evaluate an arithmetic expression written in infix notation. On the other hand, it is easier if we follow a two-step process. So that means, what are the two steps? First, transform the infix to postfix. Then, in second step, evaluate the postfix. So for evaluating any arithmetic expression that is written in infix notation, we can follow these two steps. So first one is transform that infix notation to postfix notation, or transform that mathematical expression written in infix notation to its equivalent postfix expression, then evaluate the postfix expression. So these two steps are written here. Evaluation of arithmetic expression, first step is transform the arithmetic expression from infix notation to postfix notation, then evaluate the arithmetic expression written in postfix notation. So these two steps we need to follow for evaluating any arithmetic expression written in infix notation. So first we will discuss how to transform the arithmetic expression from infix to postfix. Okay, so before going to the detail, we need to know about the priorities or about the order of evaluation or precedence and associativity of the arithmetic operators. So first we know that exponentiation has highest priority, we have discussed just now, then multiplication and division, then addition and subtraction. So exponentiation has highest priority, then multiplication and division has the same priority, but it has less priority than exponentiation. And in step 3, plus and minus have the same priority, but it is less than, their priority is less than multiplication and division. So this is all about the priority of operators. Now we will discuss the associativity. That means if two operators having same priority are there, we need to evaluate the left one or right one. So for example, we can say, suppose 2 plus 3 minus 1 is there. So we know that plus and minus have same priority. So first we evaluate plus or first we evaluate minus. So in this case, this plus and minus are left to right associative. So if we found two operators having same priority, then we need to check their associative. So whether they are left to right associative or right to left associative. So plus and minus are left to right associative. Similarly, multiplication and division are left to right, but exponentiation is right to left. So here, as these plus and minus are left to right, so first we evaluate the leftmost one, that is first we evaluate 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5, then minus 1, that is equal to 4. But if it is like this, 1 exponentiation 2 exponentiation 3, so here exponentiation operation is there, two exponentiation operation are there, so we need to evaluate the first one or second one, or the left one or the right one. So for that we need to check their associative. That means whether they are left to right associative or right to left associative. We know that the exponentiation operation is right to left associative, so for that we need to evaluate this rightmost one first, that means 1 exponentiation 8, then 1 exponentiation 8 is 1. So similarly, we can take another example. So if it is 2 exponentiation 3 exponentiation 4, so it is equal to 2 exponentiation 3 to the power 4, that is 81, and it is equal to 2 to the power 81, because first we need to evaluate this one. So this one evaluate first because it is right to left associative, then evaluate second. Okay, but if we have 2 multiplication 3 multiplication 4, so this one evaluate first because multiplication is left to right associative. Evaluate first, and it one is evaluate second. So now the left to right associative and right to left associative and the priority is clear to everyone. So except the exponentiation operation, all other operators are left to right associative. Only exponentiation operator is right to left associative. Okay, so we will proceed to the steps or to the discussion how to convert or how to transform one infix notation to its equivalent postfix notation. So for that we will see one example. Suppose a plus b, so it is written in infix notation because the operator sits in between the operands. So what is its equivalent postfix notation? So its equivalent postfix notation is a b plus. So in postfix notation the operator follows the operands, so after operands we need to write the operator. Similarly, if a multiplication b division c is there, so it is in fixed notation, a multiplication b division c. So what is its equivalent postfix notation? So that is equal to a b multiplication then c then division. So it is the equivalent postfix notation of a multiplication b division c. So using a stack we can easily convert or transform one infix notation to postfix notation. It is not like that you need to use a stack mandatorily to convert infix to postfix, but if we use a stack then we can easily transform the infix to postfix notation. So now we will see how we can convert or transform infix to postfix using stack. So we will proceed with one example. Okay, so now let us assume the small one first, a multiplication b division c. So here a b c are operands and multiplication and divisions are operators. So first take a stack, and initially the stack is empty, so it is infix and we need to write its equivalent postfix. Okay, so now read the infix notation. First read a, so it is one operand, so directly write a in the postfix. Then read the next one, that is multiplication, it is the operator. Now check the stack, it is empty, so push this multiplication operator into the stack. Okay, now b, read b, so b is operand, so directly write b in the postfix. Then read the next symbol, that is division. So now check which operator is at top of the stack. So here division and here multiplication, so they have same precedence. So first we will check for the precedence. So multiplication and division has same priority or same precedence. So if they have the same priority, then we go for their associativity, whether they are left to right associative or right to left associative. Now we know that this division and multiplication are left to right associative, so pop the element that is at the top of the stack and write that in the postfix. So here multiplication is popped and written after AB. So now the stack is empty. Now the stack is empty. So as the stack is empty, no other operators are there in the stack. Push this division into the stack. Now read the next token or next symbol. So next is C. So directly write C here in the postfix. Now we have reached at the end of the infix notation. So when you reached at the end of the infix notation, pop all the elements from the stack and make the stack empty. So here only one element, one notation is there in the stack, or one operator is there in the stack. So pop that one and write in the postfix notation. So we get a b multiplication c division at the equivalent postfix notation of A multiplication B division C. So we'll take another example. Okay, suppose the expression given in infix notation is a division b exponentiation c plus d multiplication e minus a or subtraction a multiplication c. So we need to find its equivalent postfix notation using a stack. Okay, so we need to write its equivalent postfix and assume this is the stack. Okay, so now read the first one, that is A. So A is the operand, so directly write A here, or I am using a different color, I shall use black one. So directly write A. Okay, now read the next one, that is division. So stack is empty, so push this division operation into the stack. Now read the next one, that is B. So B is operand, so directly write B here. Okay, then exponentiation, the next symbol, so read exponentiation. Now check which at the top of the stack, division. We are reading exponentiation. Exponentiation has higher precedence or higher priority than this division, so the exponentiation is pushed into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is C. C is operand, so directly write C here, or write C in black color. Okay, C here. Now read the next one, so the next one is plus, which at the top of the stack, exponentiation. So plus has lower priority than exponentiation, so we cannot push plus into the stack. So in that case, this exponentiation needs to be popped. So pop exponentiation and write here. So write here. Okay, now pop, this exponentiation is popped. Now we are reading this plus, and which at the top, division. So the plus has lower priority than division, so division is popped and written here. So division is popped and written here. Okay, so division is popped. Now the stack is empty, we are reading plus, so push plus into the stack. Okay, now read the next one, so the next symbol we are reading is D. So D is operand, so directly write D here. Now read the next one, the next symbol is multiplication. Multiplication has higher precedence than plus, because plus is at the top of the stack, so multiplication is pushed into the stack, so you can write multiplication here. Okay, now read the next one, so the next symbol is E. So directly write E here, directly write E here. Okay, then read the next one, the next symbol, that is subtraction or minus. So compare that symbol with the, or that operator with top of the stack. So in top of the stack we have multiplication, and now we are reading subtraction. So subtraction has lower precedence than multiplication, so we cannot push subtraction into the stack. And now the multiplication needs to be popped from the stack, and we should write multiplication here. So multiplication is popped. Okay, now we are reading subtraction, and addition is at the top of the stack, so they have same priority. So at the time we need to check whether they are left to right associative or right to left associative. We have discussed that this subtraction and addition are left to right associative, so this addition needs to be popped out from the stack. So addition is popped and we need to write it here. Okay, now we are reading this subtraction and the stack is empty. So push this subtraction into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is A. So directly write A here, or use a different color, black. Directly write A here. Now read the next symbol, that is multiplication, and the subtraction is at the top of the stack. So push multiplication into the stack, because multiplication has higher priority than subtraction. Now read the next symbol, that is C. So C is one operand, so directly write C here, or you can use a different one, directly write C here. So after reading C, we have reached at the end of the infix notation. So just pop the operators that are in the stack. So if we pop the operators, so first we need to pop the multiplication, because multiplication is at the top of the stack, then this subtraction is to be popped. Now the stack is empty. So we get the equivalent postfix notation is like this, that is A, B, C exponentiation, then division, then D, E multiplication, plus A, C multiplication, then minus. So this is the equivalent postfix notation. Okay, so here in postfix notation, while we are going to evaluate the precedence of operators, or the priority of operators do not have any role. Okay, we'll see some more examples. Okay, let's, the infix notation is like this. The infix is like this: A division B, and parenthesis is there, then exponentiation C plus D, here also parenthesis, then multiplication, then E minus A, here also parenthesis, then multiplication C. Okay, so we need to find its equivalent postfix. So first create a stack similar to the previous discussion. Assume we have created the stack, and initially the stack is empty. Okay, so read one by one symbol. So first the symbol is left parenthesis, so push that into the stack. So whenever you read left parenthesis, directly push that into the stack. Then the next symbol is A, so A is the operand, so directly write A there in the postfix. Then the next symbol is division. Now check the stack. So here at the top of the stack, left parenthesis is there. So whenever left parenthesis is there, is at the top of the stack, it is similar to the empty stack. You can assume the stack is empty and push the operator. So here division is pushed into the stack. Now the next one, next symbol is B, so directly write B here. Now read the next symbol, that is right parenthesis. So whenever you find a right parenthesis, just pop the operators from the stack until you get a left parenthesis. So here we are reading right parenthesis, so pop the operator, that is division. So division is popped and written here. Now we are getting left parenthesis, so pop the left parenthesis. Okay, now read the next symbol, that is exponentiation. The stack is empty, so push the exponentiation into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is left parenthesis. So whenever you find a left parenthesis, directly push that into the stack. Then the next symbol is C, so directly write C here, because C is one operand. Then the next one is plus, so plus is operand, parenthesis is at the top of the stack, so push pop plus into the stack. Then read the next one, that is D, D is operand, so directly write D here. Now read the next one, that is right parenthesis. So whenever you find a right parenthesis, pop the operators from the stack until you encounter a left parenthesis. So plus is popped and written here. Plus is popped and left parenthesis is also popped. Okay. Now the next one is multiplication. So multiplication. So who is at the top of the stack? The operator exponentiation is at the top of the stack, and we are reading multiplication. And we know that multiplication has lower precedence than this exponentiation. So we cannot push multiplication into the stack. So here exponentiation needs to be popped. So pop this exponentiation. Okay. So now the stack is empty and we are reading multiplication. So push multiplication into the stack. Okay. Now read the next one, that is left parenthesis. So put or push left parenthesis into the stack. Now read the next one, that is E. So E is operand, so directly write E here. Then push the next symbol, that is subtraction or minus operator. So check the top of the stack. So in top of the stack, left parenthesis is there. So push subtraction or minus into the stack. Now read the next one, that is A. So A is the operand, so directly write A here. Now read the next one, that is right parenthesis. So whenever you find a right parenthesis, just pop the operators until you find a left parenthesis. So here subtraction is popped and written here. So subtraction is popped, then we pop the left parenthesis. Okay. Now multiplication, read the next one, that is multiplication. So check the top of the stack. In top of the stack, we have multiplication. We are reading multiplication. They have same priority. So if we encounter two operators having same priority, then we need to check their associativity. So multiplication is left to right associative. So we cannot push this one. We cannot push this into the stack. So we pop this one. So first pop this one. So pop this multiplication that is at the top of the stack. So we pop this one. Okay. So if we pop this one, the stack becomes empty. So now we can push this multiplication. So we can push this multiplication that we are reading now. So push this multiplication. Okay. Now read the next symbol, that is C. So C is operand, so directly write C here. So after reading C, we reached at the end of the expression. So just pop the operators that are in the stack. So only one multiplication operator is there. So just pop and write here. So pop this one. Okay. So the equivalent postfix expression is this one. So we'll take another example for evaluating, for converting the infix to postfix. Okay. So here we can take the notation in infix is A plus B multiplication C minus D exponentiation E exponentiation F. We need to find its equivalent postfix. So first create a stack that is empty. Okay. So read the symbols from left to right. So first read A, so it is operand, so directly write A. Then read the next symbol, that is plus operator, the stack is empty, so push plus into the stack. Then read the next symbol, that is B, so directly write B here. Then read the next one, next symbol, that is multiplication. Plus is at the top of the stack and multiplication has higher precedence than plus. So push multiplication into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is C is operand, so directly write C here. Then the next symbol, that is minus. So multiplication is at the top of the stack. So we need to pop this multiplication. We need to pop this multiplication. So for that, we write multiplication here. Now this multiplication is popped. Now we are reading subtraction, and plus or addition is at the top of the stack, and we know that both addition and subtraction have same priority, so we need to check their associativity. And we know that addition and subtraction are left to right associative, so for that this plus is going to be popped and written here. So this plus is written here after popped. Now the stack is empty, so push this subtraction or minus into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is D. So D is operand, so directly write D here. Then read the next one, that is exponentiation, which at the top of the stack. So in top of the stack it is subtraction, and we are reading exponentiation, and we know that exponentiation has higher priority, so exponentiation is pushed into the stack. Now read the next one, that is E. So E is the operand, so directly write E here. Then push the next one, that is exponentiation, which at the top of the stack, exponentiation. So they have the same priority. We are reading exponentiation, and exponentiation is also at the top of the stack. So we need to check their associative, whether they are left to right associative or right to left associative. So exponentiation is right to left associative. So in that case, we need to push this exponentiation into the stack. So just push this exponentiation. Now read the next one, next symbol, that is F. So F is operand, directly write F. Now after reading F, we have reached at the end, so just pop the operators that are in the stack. So if we pop the operators like this one, so two exponentiations and then the subtraction, so we find that this is the equivalent postfix notation. We will take another example for converting infix to postfix. Okay, assume the expression written in infix is like this one, a plus b multiplication c plus d division f plus d multiplication e. Okay, so we need to find its equivalent postfix notation. So we can create a stack. Initially this stack is empty. Okay, so now read the first one, first symbol, that is a. So a is operand, so directly write here. Then the next one, plus operator, the stack is empty, so push plus. Then the next one, b operand, so directly write b here. Then the next one, multiplication, so which at the top of the stack, plus addition is at the top of the stack. We are reading multiplication, so multiplication has higher precedence or higher priority, so push this multiplication into the stack. So we write multiplication here. Now read the next symbol, that is read the next symbol, that is left parenthesis. So directly push the left parenthesis here into the stack. Then read the next symbol, that is C. So C is operand, so directly write C here. Now read the next one, that is plus, which at the top of the stack, in top of the stack left parenthesis is there, so you can push plus into the stack. Now read the next one, that is D. So D is operand, so directly write D here. Now read the next symbol, that is right parenthesis. So when you read a right parenthesis, pop the operators from the stack until you get a left parenthesis. So we are reading right parenthesis, so pop the elements or pop the operators until we get a left parenthesis. So pop this plus, then pop this one left parenthesis also. So pop this plus and write here, and pop the left parenthesis. Okay, so now read the next one, that is division. So we are reading division and multiplication is at the top of the stack. So they have same priority. So in that case, we need to check their associativity. We know that this division and multiplication are left to right associative. So in that case, this multiplication needs to be popped. So we need to pop multiplication and write here. So this one is popped. Now who is at the top of the stack? This plus, and we are reading division, and division has higher precedence. So we need to push division into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is f. So f is the upper end, so directly write f here. Okay, so now read the next symbol, that is addition. Who is at the top of the stack? Division is at the top of the stack. Plus has less precedence as compared to division, so division needs to be popped out. So division is popped. Okay, so now we are reading plus. This plus is at the top of the stack. So for that we need to check their associative. So the plus is left to right associative. So this plus needs to be popped and written here. So plus is popped and written here. Now the stack is empty. So push this plus into the stack. Okay. So now read the next symbol. So the next symbol is D, that is upper end, so directly we write D here. So read the next symbol, that is multiplication. So multiplication has higher precedence than plus, that is at the top of the stack. So just push multiplication into the stack. Now read the next one, that is E. So E is upper end, so directly write E here. So after reading E, we have reached at the end. So now just pop the operators that are in the stack. So if we pop the operators, so first one is multiplication, then plus. Now the stack is empty. So the equivalent postfix notation is this. Okay. So we'll see another example for converting infix to postfix expression. Okay, so let us assume the infix notation is like this, or the infix expression is like this: a plus b exponentiation d division e minus f plus g. Okay, so we need to write its equivalent postfix expression. So take a stack, initially this stack is empty. Okay, so first read the symbols that are given in the infix expression. So here first read left parenthesis. So push that left parenthesis into the stack. So we pushed the left parenthesis. Then read the next symbol, that is A. So A is operand, so directly write A here. Then read the next symbol, that is plus. So left parenthesis is at the top of the stack, so just push plus. Now read the next symbol. So the next symbol is B, that is operand, so directly write B here. Now read the next symbol, that is exponentiation. So addition is at the top of the stack, or plus is at the top of the stack, and exponentiation has higher priority than plus. So push this exponentiation into the stack. Then read the next one, that is D. So D is the upper end, so directly write D here. Then read the next symbol, that is right parenthesis. So whenever you encounter a right parenthesis, just pop the operators from the stack until you get a left parenthesis. So just pop this exponentiation, then pop the plus. After that we reach the left parenthesis. So we need to pop this one, this one, this one. Okay. Now read the next symbol, that is division. The stack is empty. So push division into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is left parenthesis. So push left parenthesis into the stack. Now read next symbol, that is E. So E is operand, so directly write E here. Now read next symbol, that is minus or subtraction. Left parenthesis is at the top of the stack, so just push subtraction into the stack. Then read the next symbol, that is F. So just push F into the stack. Okay. Now read the next one, that is right parenthesis. So just pop the elements until we encounter a left parenthesis. So subtraction is popped and the left parenthesis is also popped. Okay. Now read the next symbol, that is plus. So division is at the top of the stack, plus has lower precedence than division, so we can just pop division and write here. Now if we pop this division, the stack becomes empty and we are reading plus, so plus is pushed into the stack. Then read the next symbol, that is G. So G is operand, so directly write G here. So after reading G, we have reached at the end of the stack, sorry, end of the infix expression. So just pop the operators that are in the stack. So we pop plus and make the stack empty. So the equivalent postfix expression is this one, ABD exponentiation plus EF minus, then division G plus. So after going through the examples, now you can write the steps or the algorithm for infix to postfix conversion. So we can write these algorithms. We can write the algorithms like this. In step one, so print the operand they arrived. So if you are reading an operand, then directly print that. Print the operand as they arrive. So if you are reading one operand, so just print the operand as you read that operand. Then in next, if the stack is empty, so if the stack is empty or simply I am writing or contents left parenthesis on top, so push the incoming operator, onto the stack. Okay. Now if you are reading, so you can write here if you are reading left parenthesis, then push it onto the stack. Then in step 4 we can write, if you are reading right parenthesis, then pop the operators from the stack, pop the operators from the stack until the left parenthesis is found, until the left parenthesis is found. Then in step 5 you can write, if you are reading an operator, or if you are reading an operator that has higher precedence or higher priority, then top of the stack, push it into the stack, push it on the stack. Now if you are reading an operator that has lower precedence, then pop the operator from the top of the stack and again compare the operator with the new top of the stack. Then in 7, if same precedence or same priority, then check the associativity rule or check the associativity. If same precedence is there, then check for the associativity. So associativity means, so in 7, in step 8, if associativity is left to right, then pop from the stack and again check with the new top of the stack. And 9, if the associativity is right to left, then push that into the stack. And 10, at the end of the expression, pop and print all the operators of the stack. So while you reach at the end of the expression, just pop all the operators from the stack and print that. Okay, so these are the steps we need to follow while converting or while transforming one infix to its equivalent postfix notation. So now we will see how to, so this is already we have discussed infix to postfix conversion. So now we will see how to evaluate the postfix notation. So for that we will check one, or we will discuss one example how to convert one post, how to evaluate one postfix expression. So let us take one example. So it is like 1, 2, 3 multiplication plus 5 subtraction. So this is the postfix expression. So we can evaluate this postfix expression using a stack. suppose one stack is there and initially this stack is empty. Now read one symbol here, so first read one. So during the evaluation process, whenever you read the operand, push that onto the stack. So you are reading one, that is operand, so push one into the stack. Then read two, that is also operand, so push two into the stack. Now read three, that is also the operand, so push three into the stack. Now read multiplication. So multiplication is a operator, is an operator. So whenever you read one operator, so just pop two operands from the stack and apply the operator and again push the result into the stack. So in this example we are reading multiplication, that is an operator. So push two elements from the stack, that is 3 and 2. So pop 3 and 2 from the stack. So first we pop 3, then 2. So just pop 3 and pop 2. So now you observe, or you can notice, first we are popping 3, or first we are performing the pop operation and we are getting 3. In second we are performing the pop operation and we are getting 2. So here 3 is the second operand, 3 is the second operand, or the right operand, and 2 is the left operand. So apply the multiplication here and the result is 6. Again push 6 into the stack. So just push 6 into the stack. So we have written this 6 into here. Okay, so now remove this one. Okay, so then proceed similarly. Then read next one, that is plus. Plus is operator, so just apply pop twice. So if we apply pop, so first 6 comes, then 1 comes. So first write 6, then 1. So 6 will be the right side of the operator and 1 will be the left side of the operator. So just pop 6 and 1. Now apply the operator, that is plus. So 1 plus 6, that is equal to 7. So just push the result 7 into the stack. Okay, so now read the next one, that is 5 operand, so push it into the stack. Now read the next one, that is minus operator, so pop 2 elements. So first apply pop, so we get 5 seats in the right side of the operator, and next apply pop again, so 7 seats on the left side of the operator, and the operator seats in the middle. So we'll get 7 minus 5, that is 2. So we are getting 2 at the result. So just push 2 into the stack. So we write 2 here. So we have reached at the end. So now 2 is in the stack. So it is equal to 2. So if we evaluate this postfix expression, we are going to get 2. Okay. So we'll see one more example on this. Okay, so it is like the postfix expression is given as 2 3 1, then multiplication, then plus, then 9, then minus. So create a stack and initially the stack is empty. So read one symbol, that is 2 operand, so push that into the stack. Then next one is 3 operand, push that into the stack. Then the next one is 1 operand, so push that into the stack. Then multiplication operator, so when we encounter or read one operator, just pop 2 operands from the stack, and first we apply pop. So if we apply pop, 1 comes out and 1 sits here right side of the operator. So 1 sits here right side of the operator. Then if we apply pop again, 3 comes out and 3 sits left side of the operator. So 3 sits here and 3 multiplication 1, that is equal to 3. So the result is again pushed into the stack. So 3 is pushed here. Okay, so now read the next one, next symbol. So the next one is plus. So plus is the operator. So again repeat the same process, that means pop. So if we apply pop, then 3 comes here, that means to the right side of the operator. So then again we apply the pop operation, then if we apply pop operation, so 2 comes and 2 sits in the left side of the operator, so 2 sits here. So 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5. So push the result into the stack, so 5 comes here. Now read the next one, that is 9 operand. So push 9 into the stack. Now read the next one, that is subtraction. So subtraction is the operator. So just pop 2 operands from the stack, and the result of first pop operation sits in the right side of the operator, and the second pop operation sits on the left side of the operator. So 5 minus 9, that is equal to minus 4. So push this result into the stack, minus 4. So now we have reached at the end of the postfix expression, and in the stack minus 4 is there. So this postfix expression is evaluated to minus 4, or is equal to minus 4. So we'll take another example for evaluating this postfix expression. Assume the postfix expression is like this: 5, 3, then plus, then 8, then 2, then minus, then multiplication. Okay, so now create a stack. So read the first symbol, that is 5, so push 5 into the stack. Then the next symbol, that is 3 operand, so push 3 into the stack. Then plus operator, so when we encounter one operator, just apply the pop operation twice, and the result of first pop operation sits on the right side of the operator, and the second pop operation sits on the left side of the operator. So we apply 5 plus 3 and we get 8. So just push the result into the stack, so 8 is pushed into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is 8. So push 8 into the stack. Now read the next one, that is 2. So just push 2 into the stack. Then read the next one, that is minus. So just apply pop twice, and the result of first pop operation sits on the right side of the operator, and the result of the second pop operation shifts on the left side of the operator. And evaluate this one, 8 minus 2, so we'll get 6. So just push the result into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is multiplication. So multiplication is operator. So when we read one operator, just apply the pop twice, and the result of first pop sits right side of the operator, and the result of second pop sits left side of the operator, and apply the evaluate the expression. So it is equal to 48. So just push the result 48 into the stack. So now we have reached at the end of the expression, and 48 is in the stack. So the result is 48. We can take one more example for the postfix evaluation, and you can see the result is, or the given postfix expression is 10, 5, plus 60, then 6, then division, then multiplication, then 8, then minus. So take a stack. Initially the stack is empty. Okay, so now read the first one, that is 10. So push 10 into the stack, because 10 is the operand. Then read the next symbol, 5. So 5 is operand, so push 5 into the stack. Then plus operator, so apply the pop operation twice and we get 15. So push 15 into the stack. Now read the next symbol, that is 60. So push 60 into the stack because 60 is the operand. Now read the next symbol, that is 6. 6 is operand, so push that into the stack. Now read the next one, that is division. Division is the operator. So when we encounter operator, apply the pop operation twice and the result of first pop sits on the right side of the operator and the result of second pop sits on the left side of the operator. So thus we get 60 division 6 and we get the result as 10. So just push the result into the stack. So 10 is pushed into the stack. Then read the next symbol, that is multiplication. So multiplication is the operator. So apply the pop operation twice and the result of first pop sits on the right side of the operator and the result of second pop sits on the left side of the operator. And if we evaluate this, we will get 150. So just push the result into the stack. Okay. So now 150 is in the stack. Read the next symbol, that is 8, operand. So push it into the stack. Now read the next one, that is minus. So operator. So apply the pop operation twice. So first we apply the pop operation and get 8. So it should be on the right side of the operator. Then we apply pop operation, then we get 150. It should be on the left side of the operator. So if we evaluate this, we will get 150 minus 8, 142. So push the result into the stack. So 142 is pushed into the stack. So now we reached at the end of the stack and 142 is there in the stack. So the result of this postfix expression is 142. So we have discussed how to evaluate the postfix expression and how to convert one infix expression to its equivalent postfix expression using stack.